Shalom. Let me give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahuwah, Bahashem Yahshai, Bahashem Rahakodash, the bonds to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone were well. And I want to say peace and blessings to sincere Akim who are doing this with interest, truth, and sincerity. I want to say Shalom and salutations. And I'm doing this video here on the late rapper Young Dolph. His name was Adolph Robert Thornton Jr. And as the news says, he was in Memphis, Tennessee at a cookie shop, and he was shot. This was November 17th. Okay, so basically, this cat was big in his community. Right, this guy was big in his community. He felt comfortable enough to be around mainly so-called Negroes. He's from the tribe of Judah, so you know he's around a lot of more impoverished Jake. You know, more bottom. Jake's at the bottom, and he goes there. He goes to that shop often. You know, and I looked up and you know, some of the beefs he had and all that stuff. He has his own label, Paper Route. You know, so he's just, you know, independent guy. So I think I heard some of his songs or whatever the case may be, but we know that these rappers here at Babylon don't have a shelf life of too long, you know. So what, this guy was in his 30s, 36, you know what I'm saying? So we know the Most High is the issues of judgment. We know that the Lord issues out his judgment every morning, and this is what happens when you in that type of lifestyle, funded by Esau Edom, that vibration, pushing that vibration upon Israel. So you know, music isn't how it used to be. Let's get the first scripture. And I mean, people are getting more desensitized to these, their rappers, their favorite, these rappers in the industry dying. And it's going to be more of them as well. Because it's really not productive when you think about it, you know. It's more of a low frequency, more of a vibration. Little vibration. This is his book of Mark 13:25. And the stars of heaven shall fall, and the powers that are in heaven shall be shaken. Okay. The stars of this world. This guy was in a camouflage Lamborghini that stands out like a sore thumb, you know. And we, person with a brain would say, why would you be driving that? So normally, you're drawing attention to yourself, you know. There's things he probably knew, but you know, thought he was the man. Now what if, whether it was a hit by Esau and his crew paying back some type of ritual, or was some street beef. I think he was beefing with CMG, Yo Gotti and them people, Black Youngster and them. So you know, we don't really know about technically who, but he's going up out of there, man. A lot of these rappers is worth more dead. 03, Nipsey Hussle, they're more worth dead. Nope, when they're no longer here, that's when they're more lucrative. For Esau Edom, of course, because he runs these record labels and the music industry, period. So this is Deuteronomy 32:15. But Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked, thou art waxing fat, thou art grown thick, thou art covered with fatness. Then he forsook the Most High, which made him, and lightly esteemed the rock of his salvation. Jeshurun is another name for Israel. Okay, and when it says Jeshurun waxed fat, he grew greatly in riches and became lackadaisical and comfortable. So, you know, when you call someone a fat cat, basically he has a lot of resources at his hands. Okay, and Israel, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you do that, mainly Judah, so-called Negroes. When they rap, you know, they like to go back to their hood and stunt and things of that nature and rap about it. You know, that's part of the game. So the Lord already knows about his people. Okay. But that nigga say he gonna grow up to be a rich little bastard. That's what he said in his song and shit, you know. You know, you see on his the cover of his album, he putting his hand in the shape of a pyramid over his eye. We know what that represents. That he is involved in the craft. And he's taking some type of oath to Lucifer. Spiritual demon Satan. So yeah, he is a sellout. Pretty much. This is Isaiah 52:3. For thus saith the Lord, ye have sold yourselves for naught, and ye shall be redeemed with no money. Okay, so you sold yourself for naught. You sold yourselves for nothing. You sold your soul. You know, people make fun of it. You know, Illuminati selling your soul. Illuminati. All that stuff is real. Pyramid, all that. All it is the left hand of the Lord. And the Lord's allowing this to happen because the Lord ultimately does not want certain individuals to be a part of the fold, of this fold, of the spirit, of the truth. All right? You don't want niggas a part of it. So you sold yourselves for naught. You can't redeem. You can't come back after that. People make videos. These rappers and these Hollywood stars. Actors. They may come out and say, well, I sold my soul and I feel bad now. Let me tell you about the industry. At that point, it's too late. When you shoot a weapon, shoot it off. There's no way of that bullet coming back. You've already done the action. So I don't want to hear nothing about that once it's already done. Okay. You knew what you were getting into when you signed up. But it's temporary. It's temporary. You know, all that. It's, you know, devil comes to collect, man. Proverbs 22:3. Let me start at 2. The rich and poor meet together. The Lord is a maker of them all. The Lord makes these guys up to be who they are, fame and fortune. You know, he sets these people up. And you know, that cuts this free will stuff. Free will. Verse 3. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hides himself, but the simple passes on and are punished. So said, prudent man can see what's going on. Now, his particular situation, everybody can say what they'll do, what they should have did, or, you know, what he should have did and stuff. Everybody's saying, you know, he shouldn't have rode around in his signature car, shouldn't have went back. You know, so he was easily to be touched. And that's all true. You know, even a regular person, though, you got to be prudent to foresee evil. You know, but if you are circumspect, it's, yeah, what it say, pass it. But the simple pass on and are punished. So if you simple, you can easily get punished because this is the valley, shadow of valley of death. So when you walk outside, you're open to all these evil spirits and dangerous spirits. So really, you know, you got to be covered or have a covering of the Lord. Okay. But yeah, he's gone, man, you know. So, you know, that's that. Too much more to say about that, man. Hey, it's what it is. So, let me give, I hope this was edifying. I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahushai, Ba'ashim, Rechakwadash, the Bars to the Apostles and the Elders at Great Millstone, who rule well, Shalom.